Rivers Church of the Nazarene. Let me be one of the first to wish you Merry Christmas. We're glad that you are here, and we have a very special evening planned for you. Some of you traditional Three River citizens might notice there's something a little different this year. Has anybody noticed anything any different? What's different? There's no trees. And let me give you a 10-second explanation why. It's not that we're throwing caution and tradition to the wind and creating anarchy in Three Rivers. Basically, I think a lot of you know that I'm recovering from cancer. And the cancer treatment kind of ran into the tree preparation, and something had to give, and it was the tree. I'm doing fine, but there wasn't enough time to put the tree together, and this would have been our 20th year of presenting the tree, and we didn't want to do it halfway. So we kind of made a decision, and we decided that we would wait and come at it from another direction. But by no means are you being shortchanged. There's something very, very special that is going to happen tonight. We're excited about it. We're ready for it. I think you can hear some of the energy. And they're going to start off. You're going to see our little tiny kids, our middle-sized kids, our big kids, and then the big kids like us. We're going to be involved in the process. You're going to see people doing incredible things. You're going to get to watch a family decorate a Christmas tree tonight. That's a unique experience. You're going to get to watch a couple people just trying to find a parking space, getting ready to do Christmas shopping. That's really unique. I think you've all been there. You're going to see some incredible events that will touch your heart. And just for us, it just seems to take us to another level of getting ready for Christmas. So I want to have a word of prayer as we officially welcome you. And then some very excited little people are going to come. We're going to sing some congregationals tonight and share together in a wonderful, cozy family Christmas. I think you've noticed you have candy and mints and nuts and little candlelight, special light just for you. And we welcome you. Would you bow your heads, please? Father, thank you for Christmas. Thank you for what it means to us. Thank you for Jesus Christ, who is the center of all of our preparation and the center of our lives. As we share this night together, may your name be glorified. May the joy of the Lord unite our hearts. May this be a celebration of a birthday of a king. And as we sing and laugh and perhaps shed a tear of joy, let your spirit be a part of all that we do. And let everyone from the community that has entered these doors know that in this church they are loved. In Jesus' name, amen.
Please join me in singing Angels We Have Heard on High. The words are in your bulletin.
Thank you. and is for the many blessings he gives me. S is for the snow that falls so pure and white and clean.
I is for the icicles that decorate the scene.
A is for the angels who announced his holy birth.
M is for the manger that became his bed on earth.
R is for rejoicing as both heaven and nature sing.
H is for the happiness that baby Jesus brings.
E is for the eastern star that shines so clear and bright.
S is for the shepherds who watched over their flock by night.
R is for the royal birth, the son of Jesse.
Y is for the young child who was born to set men free.
R is for remembering of what it is we sing.
C is for Christ of Christmas, let us praise us. Let us praise him.
Something that we should take out. like them?
Oh yeah, they're fabulous. Except they might get in our way when we try to play games. You don't mind, do you?
No, I guess not. Well, I thought charades would be...
Charades? I love charades! That is an awesome game!
Now let's see, 4 and 14, maybe some weird crowd here. You can control it,
Hey, what about me?
You don't like something that's not me.
Well, no, I guess not, but you do know it's my birthday. It's a birthday party. Okay, they are forgetting whose it's really for. It's for me. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you. 'twas the night before Christmas, and my only desire was peace among kids and to rest by the fire. I just settled down in my favorite chair when I heard a small voice and a cry of despair. As I stared at the hearth, I saw a strange sight. Our nativity scene in the flickering light seemed almost alive, but how could this be? One lonely shepherd was calling to me. Move me closer, move me closer, move me closer to the child. Let me see. So with a shake of the head and a rub of the eyes, I took another look, and what did I see? Without a doubt, he was looking at me. It seems in the hustle and the bustle of things, in the wrapping of gifts and the building of swings, in assembling his scene, I'd been a bit hurried, and understandably so, he was a little bit worried.
Christmas tree this year, so
okay, well,
hopefully
Surprise! Well, it's our Christmas tree. So what do you think? Huh?
I hope the neighbors did not see you bring that into our
Honey,
home.
You'd be so proud of me. I got it half off.
Is the half off referring to the branches being half off or half off the price?
Well, I'll open it a little bare.
No, when the wind was whistling through the branches of this tree, I think it was singing an opera.
Where have all the branches? No, that's an opera, right? Okay, let's stop and think about it. It does need some help, doesn't it? But you know what? We can just put some tinsel on it and we'll fix it.
Probably just to keep it warm.
I really believe, at least on the back here, we can do some ornaments, y'all. I've got some really cool ornaments.
You're going to have to be careful keeping them all nice and even.
And even though it's kind of leaning a little bit, right up here on top, we'll put this really cool treetop ornament, honey.
Be good for a lightning rod.
Something tells me you don't like this tree.
Well, maybe it looked nice in the store, but dragging it home behind the car didn't help any.
Actually, it looked just like this in the store.
Did it catch your attention or something?
Well, no, there were lots of beautiful, green, full, wonderful Christmas trees there, but yeah, I guess somehow it just kind of caught my attention.
Probably because the termites were chomping away at it, and you could hear them.
Okay, just go ahead, laugh at me, but just trust me. You know how I can fix things. Just trust me. I'm going to make this the most beautiful tree that we've ever had.
Was it the last one left, or what was the deal?
No, there were lots of them there, but...
Okay, fine.
It kind of had an appeal to me.
All right.
Okay, now really, all it needs is some warm tinsel and some ornaments, and here, let's put some bulbs on it. Okay, here, have a bowl. Careful where you put it.
Yeah, my selection is limited here where I can put it. Watch it, it's gonna start leaning, be careful.
Okay, this is gonna be interesting here. Okay, now we need to put some lights on it.
You know, I hope these are the flashing kind. At least half the time it'll be in the dark.
Scientific process to all this. Oh no, we lost the bowl.
Really,
have you checked these to make sure they work?
Yes, I did, dear. Okay. I'm a perfectionist,
yeah. Yeah.
Unlike you.
Boy, if you're a perfectionist, you respect you. I'm bringing this kind of tree.
Yes, it is. Very
much. I'm having a little trouble here. Oh well. Okay, now we've got the lights. And now look at this cool tinsel I got. Isn't this cool? This is state of the art tinsel, multicolored.
Wait. I definitely would not.
See, it's got a smiley face in it. It's a happy Christmas tree.
You were pushing your luck. I don't think this tree is going to be able to hold all this.
Okay. Well, talk to me. Look. No, wait. Okay, this is good. Okay. Right now, you ready for the resistance? I worked, and I almost went chopping for this. I got really, really creative. I got this really cool treetop ornament, and it's going to go right up here if the tree doesn't fall over. Okay? Now, there. I'll turn it this way so you can see it better. No, I'll turn it that way. I'll turn it. But, wait, do you have a preference?
It's fine. I would like to.
Good.
Good.
Yes, it wasn't actually the mom.
Thank you. Christmas presents. All right, guys. This year, we're opening gifts. We're opening them in an orderly fashion.
Right.
Come on. I don't want this to be repeated last year.
Right.
I said, I don't want this to be repeated last year. Come on, put the gifts back. Put them back. I've decided this Christmas is going to last longer than the 30 seconds it takes to rip the wrappings off the gifts.
Well, we could stretch it out for 45 seconds, but that's throwing in all the thank yous.
My point exactly. Why do you always have to be in such a rush?
Are you saying you want your kids to open the presents at one at a time?
Okay, last time we did that, after warranty expired, we got the last
one. All I want us to do is take time to remember what this day really means. Christmas. Christmas is Jesus' birthday. That's what we're celebrating.
We know that, but we just get so excited.
Look, there's nothing wrong with getting excited to go over gift giving or any of the other festivities. It's just that for once, can't we have more than dried pine needles in the carpet and February charge card statements to remember Christmas by?
Yeah, you're right. Why is it such a hurry to open the gifts and get the turkey on the table that we just tear through them and then we sing one bar of Christmas?
This Christmas is going to be different. The presents will wait. The turkey can take always use more time in the oven. This year, we're going to invite him to the celebration. They came to pass these days with the mild decree from Caesar Augustus. All the world should be taxed. And all went to be taxed, everyone in his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Judea, into the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, to be taxed from Mary's espoused wife, being great with child.
And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid.
And suddenly, there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to the Lord. Now we can celebrate Christmas.
Wait, let's do one more thing.
Silent
night,
holy
night,
all is gone. Merry Christmas. Thank you.
My father told me that I was to take a wife. Now keep in mind, love was a rare thing in those days, but I loved Mary from the first time I saw her face. We began our year-long engagement. She would become my wife. She would bear me a strong son, and I would train him to be a carpenter, just like my father and my grandfather. Yes, my life was to be lived just like my father. Mary and I began our year-long engagement. We were so excited. Great sense of anticipation of what our life would become here in a small carpenter shop, fulfilling the tradition of our family. And suddenly, horribly, everything changed. Mary had been with another man. She was going to have his baby. To make matters worse, she tried to tell me some story about an angel and how God made this baby come alive in her womb. And I was so angry with her, I was ready to break off the engagement, take her out and have her stoned, as is a custom of our law. I would have been perfectly within my rights to end her life. And I would have done it too. And I had a visit from an angel. Oh, at first, I didn't know he was an angel, for he looked just like any other man. But when he spoke, this incredible peace came over me. I fell to my feet. Joseph, son of David. Do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins. Suddenly, everything Mary had said made sense. I went and found her, and we laughed, and we cried, and we rejoiced, and we actually trembled at the excitement of this news. We were so young for such a task. But God knew we would obey him, no matter what we asked. Somehow, though, our friends would never fully understand. We just knew everything was going to be all right. Mary and I were very eager for the birth of our son. Even though I was not the father, I knew I would love Jesus from the moment that I met him, the day that he came into the world. And we knew that day was very, very near when we received terrible news. The news came through the Roman soldiers. Every Jew had to travel to the place of his birth for a new tax sentence. Understand the impact for us. My wife was ready to give birth any day, and we had to make a journey of over 80 miles from Nazareth in the north of Galilee to Bethlehem by Jerusalem. I thought, how in the world could we possibly do this and get back to our home and our friends and our family before the baby was born? And we thought of trying to avoid it, but we've learned that to ignore the Romans has the penalty. So we made our plans for our journey. I was actually excited when I was able to buy a donkey for Mary. Perhaps that would speed up the journey a little bit and we'd be able to get back home before the baby was born. The dusty roads were crowded with lines of tired, frustrated people. No one was happy about this. We walked along those endless lines, and often we would have to jump out of our way as a Roman centurion came charging by on his speeding chariot. The day before we arrived in Bethlehem, nearing the end of a long journey, Mary became so uncomfortable. I was so worried for her. The next afternoon, we arrived in Bethlehem, and I knew her time was near. Can you imagine my disappointment when I found that every room in every inn in that great city was filled to capacity? The realization began to dawn on me that perhaps we would bring the Christ child into the world on the site of a dusty, dirty Bethlehem street. How grateful I was to the innkeeper who found the barn. Stable. It was warm, dry, and also quiet. I quickly made a bed for Mary and tried to make her as comfortable as I could. It seemed like hours, but really just a very short period of time. She gave birth to our son. The innkeeper had summoned a lady from nearby, and she was so tender, gracious and helpful to Mary. She wrapped our baby boy in strips of cloths. I made him a bed of hay in a feeding trough. And that was the place where Jesus spent his first night on this earth. Later that night, Mary and I were both so weary. Jesus was calm when we heard a knock on the barn door. I cautiously opened the door, wondering who would be coming to us in the middle of the night, and I found a group of shepherds who were very, very animated and very excited, and they began to talk to us, and their very first question was, "Where is the Christ child? We want to see the Christ child. Please take us to the Christ child." And I thought, my, how could this be? How could these shepherds have heard this news so far out in their fields, watching their flocks? the story of angelic visits and choirs from heaven. The night was filled with awe and wonder. They spent several hours with us that night. And yet during that whole time, they hardly spoke a word. There was so much of God in that room. So much peace. A wonderful sense of his presence. With the dawn, the shepherds began to spread the word of the event, and all throughout the town, people began to get excited. It was like a wonderful celebration taking place, and they would come by, and they would knock on the door, and during the day, we'd just open the doors wide, and people would come in and say, "Where is the Christ child? Where is the Christ child?" And they would visit with our son Jesus, and then leave with an attitude of celebration. And all over the little town of Bethlehem, we could hear the shouts of the people, "The Christ child has come! The Christ child has come!" What a tremendous event. I'll never forget it. Neither will I ever fully understand it all. How could the great Jehovah God trust the growth and development of the Messiah of the world? I've never really gotten over the visit from the angels. It changed me forever. Nor will I ever fully comprehend the remarkable events of those days. I know it was only a cow barn, a bed of hay. But that place will always be holy to me. Somehow, sitting on a pile of hay next to Mary and a little baby named Jesus, I knew that that baby was going to change the world. Stop and think about it. I felt the Son of God in my arms. Jehovah God, may all who hear the story of Jesus give their lives and their love to him. And as he forgives their sins and fills their hearts with his joy, may you, God, be glorified. Amen. The evening is over. We've shared Christmas. We've told you the story once again in a unique and beautiful way. We've opened our hearts and extended our love to you. Our investment in a city that we love and a people that we love. I hope that you've heard loud and clear that the reason we do all of this is to glorify one whose name is Jesus. It's our heartfelt hope that if there's anyone in this room who does not know him right now as your personal Lord and Savior, that you would bow your head and ask him to come into your heart and to live all your days in this kind of a relationship with him. That's why we do all this, so that Jesus is glorified and honored. I'd like to have a closing word of prayer with you. Before I do so, let me thank you so very, very much for coming. Did you like the cozy family Christmas atmosphere? And you've had your mints and your candy, and I have some good news for you. There's more in the back. So if you didn't catch the announcement and come early and get some, we've made extra provision, and just go right down the hallway, and there's coffee and cake and punch and candy and peanuts and nuts and all sorts of things, and time to fellowship and just have some refreshment. And that's just another way that we can tell you how much you mean to us and how much this night means. Would you bow your heads? Father, I thank you for the Christ of Christmas. We live in a society that can so quickly forget that the word Christmas is based on your name. Tonight, through very humorous ways and very serious ways, we have endeavored to tell the Christmas story, to share once again the fact that Jesus Christ loves us, and from his birth to his death, he lives for us. Father, how I pray that everyone in this room would know you and love you as Lord and Savior of your life. I pray that our community would be touched by this time, and in this Christmas season, may we truly act out the gifts of love and expression that we know in our hearts we should do. May we find ways to care for one another, and may we do it all in your name. Thank you for the peace in this room. Thank you for the joy that fills our hearts. And thank you for sending your son Jesus. In his holy name we pray. Amen. Just before you go, we have a couple people that we need to honor. And we have Carol McCauley and Mary Beth, please. Front and center. Christmas to all and to all.
Playing around or anything.